It's hard not to notice a few more seats in the press box are filled. There's fewer open seats behind home plate. The scouts are in the building, hoping to add a coveted merit badge or two for their organization. The unsettling reality of being sellers at the trade deadline. Well, among the folks in attendance, sizing up the Tigers' trade prospects, MLB.com's at Fox Sports' John Paul Morosi. And for a guy like you, this is your favorite
this
time.
Is this Christmas. Is like Christmas. This is Christmas every single day. I love
it. He's dressed like it's Christmas, too. Why is he always out-dressing us? Always making us look bad.
Jeez. All right. Well, we'll forgive that once again. Of course, a lot of speculation, obviously, surrounding the Tigers, John Paul, including Justin Verlander. What's the latest on a possible deal for him?
Well, Mick, both the Dodgers and Astros had scouts in attendance Friday for JV's start here at Comerica Park, and I still think those are the two most likely candidates to land him. But I'll say this as well, Mick. The Tigers are now, I'm sensing, a little more willing to maybe put in a bit of cash in the deal to facilitate that trade if the right prospect package is there. One note there, the Yankees, they just lost Michael Pineda for the year, but I'm told not really hot on JV at this time.
Why do we keep hearing that the Tigers have to add money for Justin Verlander? He's making $28 million. He nearly won a Cy Young last year. He hasn't been quite that good this year, but if you look at some of his games, they haven't scored a lot of runs for him. $28 million is not all that much for a starter like Verlander, is it?
Well, it's a fair point, Rod. I think there are some more affordable names. Sonny Gray makes less. I think Jay Happ with the Jays makes less. I think there are enough pitchers out there that make a lower salary that they would probably say, I'm not going to pay that premium.
They don't have that resume, though.
They don't. But again, Rod, I think so many times in baseball, especially at the deadline, it's all about how does he look right now. And I do think, though, Verlander, with the health we saw, the fastball, the life is still there. His start in Cleveland was excellent, so they still think a lot of robust interest in JV.
Now, John Paul, lefty relievers are always desired at this time of year. Who's at the top of that list right now?
Well, Justin Wilson right now for the Tigers, a lot of teams like him. I would continue to add the Astros and Dodgers are both in the mix on him, as well as the Nationals and Brewers. And there's the competition, the rest of the market. How about Zach Britton, just coming off the DL? He is up, guys. After next year, the Orioles may just have Brad Brock close for them in the future and market Britton. The Dodgers, among many teams that like him. And check out Tony Cingrani. They're a bit of a under-the-radar name, but they have Cingrani and Raisel Iglesias as well, drawing a lot of interest from teams.
Are you hearing that teams are calling the Tigers on Justin Wilson?
Yes, in a big way. Again, I think, actually, Rod, I would tell you that Justin Wilson, from what I can tell from sources, is the Tigers' most marketable trade chip. I think basically 10, maybe even 15 teams at different times in the last 6 or 7 months have called on Justin Wilson.
What could he bring back, possibly?
It's a great question. I think it's maybe not quite what we saw for Aroldis Chapman last year, because he doesn't have quite that number of years and saves as a closer. But I think the prospect package is certainly a little bit south of that. But I think it's certainly enough that you could probably get at least an everyday player and maybe an arm as well.
Now, what about J.D. Martinez? I think you reported the Diamondbacks had expressed some interest.
Yes, Mickey. A lot of action right now for J.D. in the National League West. When you think about the NL West, so many lefty starters. Kershaw, Wood, Bumgarner, Ray, Corbin. And with all those lefties, those two teams, the Rockies and Diamondbacks, would like to get J.D. Martinez to help them, I think, against that lefty pitching. And the Rockies, Rod, you wouldn't normally think it because they've got Cargo in right field, but he is having his worst season of his career.
And if you think about J.D., he is absolutely clobbered a left-handed pitching all season long. So he'd be a nice fit in any outfield that's looking for a middle-of-the-order bat. How about some of the other guys that we've been hearing about as far as the Tigers? I guess Miggy not really going anywhere. Right. How about Iglesias? How about Ian Kinsler? We've heard all these names. How about Alex Avila? We just had him on our pregame show.
Well, I would mention with Alex, Rod, the interest from the Cubs is still there. We talked about how the Cubs had interest in both Verlander and Alex at one point in time. And I was told recently that the interest in Alex is still there on the part of the Chicago Cubs. They have continued those conversations. And Alex's numbers, Rod, check that out right there. Best OPS of any catcher in the majors this year. That's how good Alex Avila has been. And I think, too, we know him, a great guy in the clubhouse, handles the staff so well, and he's also comfortable, Rod. If he has to play every day, he can do it. If it's a part-time role, he can do that as well. So I think he checks so many boxes for a contending club like the Cubs.
That's a great point. You bring out the fact that he can start or he can back up, because he's already filled both of those roles and he's done it marvelously. But when you start talking about his OPS and what he's already done, he's comeback player of the year right now for the American League. That's how well he's performed.
strong candidate to do that. And I think to your other question, Rod, about Iglesias and Kinsler, the market for middle infielders maybe not quite as robust as it has been in other years. But with the Cardinals needing a shortstop, a glove-first shortstop, I would say watch Iglesias closely there.
Right. Rod and I disagree on this strongly. Is there any way the Tigers trade Michael Fulmer? Is there a deal out there that could possibly make that happen?
Possibly, but I would say it's remote right now. Actually, I was told by a source, Mickey, that the package that the Cubs actually gave up to the White Sox to get Quintana was also offered to the Tigers for Fulmer. So similar type package. Again, those same names.
And Eloy that was Jimenez, a pretty good package
and a
that
pretty good
the
package.
White Sox were
yes,
able to get from
a
the
very
Cubs.
Good package, but the Tigers said no, again, according to my source. When you think about that, it makes sense because you think about Fulmer, how young he still is. Look at how good he has been. Every team in the game wants a Michael Fulmer. And even this, guys, even if we think about the Tigers having a rebuild, if that ends up being the direction they take, so it maybe takes 3 years, however many years it takes, Fulmer is still going to be here in 3 years. In fact, the Tigers have 5 years of control over Fulmer after this year is done. There is absolutely no urgency to trade Michael Fulmer right now.
That's what I mean. Building block, not a trade chip. Enough of
long-term
that.
Piece.
Enough of that nonsense, hey, Rod.
Would you like to do the rest of the show with Mickey?
No, I've started the fire now. I'm going to walk away very carefully.
We love each other. Right, we have you on speed dial, so don't go far.
Sounds
because
good.
Anything pops, we'll give you a call. All right, JP, thank you so much. John Paul.